We use the chain rule for differentiating complex functions and substitution for integration. In today's video, I'll show you a simple and quick way to differentiate and integrate without using chain rule or substitution. This video will be part of a series, and today is the first video where I will explain fast differentiation and integration using the power rule. In the future, I will continue to upload videos on cases involving exponentials, logarithms, trigonometric functions, and more. We'll be using a lot of boxes in the upcoming equations, so for convenience, I'll refer to the method I'm explaining as the box rule. To understand how this box rule was created, let's solve a problem using the chain rule. Suppose we have a y equals 4x squared minus 7x plus 1 to the power of 3, and we want to find dy by dx. To differentiate, we'll substitute u as 4x squared minus 7x plus 1, so now y becomes u to the power of 3. The result we want to find is dy by dx, but suddenly u has appeared, so we need to change the expression of dy by dx to include u. This is where the chain rule comes in, and dy by dx now becomes dy by du times du over dx. To find dy by dx, we need to calculate dy by du inside the yellow box, and du over dx inside the green box, and then multiply them. So let's first find dy by du. If we differentiate y shown right above as u, it becomes 3u squared, and we differentiate u with respect to x, it becomes 8x minus 7. Now, let's multiply these two to write dy by dx. Dy by dx is 3u squared times 8x minus 7. If we replace u with the expression 4x squared minus 7x plus 1, it becomes 3 times 4x squared minus 7x plus 1 to the power of 2 times 8x minus 7. To further simplify, the derivative of 4x squared minus 7x plus 1 to the power of 3 is 3 times 4x squared minus 7x plus 1 squared times 8x minus 7. Taking a closer look, we can see that the derivative of the box to the power of 3 is 3 times box to the power of 3 minus 1 times box prime. In this case, the expression inside the box is 4x squared minus 7x plus 1. And the box prime contains the derivative of the previous white box, which is 8x minus 7. Now, let's consider the general case for an exponent of n. The derivative of the box to the power of n is n times box to the power of n minus 1 times box prime. Using this formula, we can easily and quickly perform differentiation without the need for the chain rule, and the same concept applies to the integration. I'll explain this in more detail with the next example. Here we have 5 sine x plus x squared to the power of 4, and we want to find its derivative. Let's bring in the box rule formula we created earlier. Comparing this formula with the problem, we can see that we need to place 5 sine x plus x squared inside the box, and the exponent n is 4. What about the expression on the right side? We also insert the same term, 5 sine x plus x squared, into the right box, and we'll change the n to 4 as well. Now, the only thing left is the green box prime, which should contain the derivative of the white box. So the box prime will have 5 cosine x plus 2x. Bring it all together, we get 4 times 5 sine x plus x squared to the power of 3, times 5 cosine x plus 2x as the answer. And we found the answer in just two lines. Now, let's explore how this box rule can be applied to integration. Here we have box to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1. And when we differentiate it, the constant term in the denominator n plus 1 remains in the denominator, and the exponent of the box n plus 1 comes down and then multiplies the box, reducing the exponent to n plus 1 minus 1. Finally, box prime is multiplied. In simplified terms, we get box to the power of n times box prime. Now, let's summarize. The derivative of the box to the power of n is n times box to the power of n minus 1 times box prime. Conversely, when you integrate box to the power of n times box prime, we get box to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c, where c is the integration constant. When you differentiate x squared plus x plus 1, we get 2x plus 1. And when we differentiate x squared plus x plus 2, we still get 2x plus 1. In fact, Even if we differentiate x squared plus x plus 1000, we end up with the same result to x plus 1. In other words, when you integrate to x plus 1, we don't know whether there will be a 1 at the end or 1000. So we add an arbitrary constant c. Now, as you perform differentiation, remember to identify which part is the box. And the final step of the differentiation, don't forget to multiply by box prime. When doing integration, the key is to identify who the box prime is first. Since the last term attached during differentiation is box prime, finding it first in integration is the key to solving problems easily. Don't forget this important step. I will explain it further with an example. Here we have y equals quarter times 5x squared minus x plus 1 to the power 4. We want to find dy over dx using the box rule formula. The 1 over 4 can be left outside as it doesn't affect the differentiation. Comparing the problem with the formula, we see that the term inside the box is 5x squared minus x plus 1, and the exponent n is 4. So let's substitute these values into the formula. Similarly, for the right-hand side, we also multiply by 1 over 4 and insert the same term, 5x squared minus x plus 1, into the box and set n to 4 as well. Now, for the final step, we put the derivative of the box, which is 10x minus 1, into the green box prime. Now, if we simplify and rewrite the answer, it becomes 5x squared minus x plus 1 to the power 3 times 10x minus 1. And this is the answer. Now, let's change the problem a bit and try to find the integral of 5x squared minus x plus 1 to the power 3 times 10x minus 1. Using the box rule for the integration that we previously found, we can compare it with the problem and easily identify that the term inside the box is 5x squared minus x plus 1 and n is 3. For the green box prime, we simply put 10x minus 1. So what's the result of the integration? We insert the same term, 5x squared minus x plus 1, into the right to right box and set n to 3. Don't forget to add plus c at the end. In summary, the answer is 5x squared minus x plus 1 to the power 4 over 4 plus c. And using the box rule, we found the integral in just two lines. Now let's explore a slightly different example. We have y equals sine cube x, and we'll use the box rule to find dy over dx easily. First, we place sine x inside the box and set n to 3. On the right side, we also set n to 3 and insert sine x into the box, just like on the left side. In the green box prime, immediately following, we put the derivative of sine x, which is cosine x. Simplifying, the answer becomes 3 times sine squared x times cosine x. And now let's move on to integrating this expression. We pull the constant 3 out and find 3 times the integral of sine squared x times cosine x dx. Let's identify the terms to fill in the blank using the box rule formula and the problem. First, we multiply the formula by 3 to match it with the problem. We insert sine x into the box and set n to 2. And for the green box prime, we use cosine x, which is right above. Once you find the box and the box prime in an integration problem, the rest becomes straightforward. On the right side, we also multiply by 3, insert sine x into the white box, and set n to 2. Now, all that left is simplifying the answer. So 3 sine cube x over 3 plus c simplifies to sine cube x plus c. How is it going? Are you starting to get the hang of it? Let's take a look at a slightly more challenging example. This time, let's find the derivative of inverse sine x to the power 3 or arcsine to the power 3. Can you see what should go inside the box? We should put inverse sine x from the parentheses into the box and set n to 3. Therefore, the right side box will also contain inverse sine x and n will be 3 as well. Now, the last and the most crucial step is to find the box prime to multiply. The derivative of the inverse sine x is 1 over square root 1 minus x squared. So we'll put this into the green box prime. Now the answer is 3 times inverse sine x to the power of 2 over square root 1 minus x squared. Now let's proceed to integrate this result. We'll pull the constant 3 out of the integral sign and write inverse sine x to the power of 2 over square root 1 minus x squared as inverse sine x to the power of 2 times 1 over square root 1 minus x squared, multiplying the denominator separately. We do this to easily distinguish the box and the box prime. Now, let's bring in the box rule formula and fill in the blanks. Inside the box, we have an inverse sine x just like in the problem, and n is set to 2. For the green box prime, we place a derivative which is 1 over square root 1 minus x squared right above. On the right side, we also multiply by 3, insert inverse sine x into the box, and set n to 2. Once we eliminate the 3 in both the numerator and denominator, the answer simplifies to inverse sine x to the power of 3 plus c. Finally, we reach the last example. In this example, to find the derivative of 2 square root sine x, let's first rewrite the expression as 2 times sine x to the power of a half. Now, it's clear who should go inside the box, right? Let's apply the box rule formula by multiplying 2 to the front, placing sine x inside the box, and setting n to half. On the right side, we also multiply by 2, insert sine x into the box, and set n to half. And finally, for the crucial green box prime, we put the derivative of sine x, which is cosine x. Upon a bit of simplification, the answer becomes sine x to the power of negative half times cosine x, which can be expressed as cosine x over square root sine x in fractional form. We found the derivative easily. Now, if we were faced with the integration problem of cosine x over square root sine x, do you know where to start? First, you need to distinguish between the box and the box prime. To make it easier, change the expression to integral of sine x to the power of negative half times cosine x dx. When you bring in the box rule formula, it is clear what should go inside the box and the box prime. Place sine x inside the box, set n to negative half, and for the box prime, insert cosine x. On the right side, sine x also goes into the box and n becomes negative half. Solving this yields sine x to the power of half over half plus c, which simplifies to 2 times square root of sine x plus c in a more concise form. Today, you'll learn a method to differentiate and integrate quickly and easily without relying on the chain rule and substitution thanks to the box rule. Our focus today was on the box rule related to the power rule. And in the future, I will continue to create videos on various cases of the box rule, including exponents, logarithms, trigonometric functions, and more. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe and like it. I sincerely thank all of you who has been watching. I will see you next time, and this has been your math guardian, Alex.